What's good, Raider Nation? It's your boy, Mikey Raider. Thank you for tuning in. If you're still ride or die with me after all this controversy and people playing the blame game, comparison, everybody being toxic, divisive within the Raider Nation, if you're still rocking with me, I appreciate it. I got a little bit emotional. Derek Carr, my quarterback, brought me out of some tough times with his faith, with his leadership. After I was sued basically by the NFL, I literally had Derek Carr subscribe to my channel, one of the first subscribers to my original Raider channel, and he sent me a couple of messages like prayers on Twitter. And he introduced me to Josh Jacobs, who left me a message. And that's why I'm very, very hurt, because Derek Carr kind of was like my everything to come back to the Raiders after I was sued by them. He's like one of the reasons why I don't know, like I got over it kind of quickly and I came back to the Raiders, you know, to root him on, to get a championship and, you know, go to playoffs and all that other stuff. So Derek Carr was a big part of my life. I'm not comparing his on-the-field gameplay and all that. We all know he's limited, and many of us are excited at the opportunity of something different, okay? I'm still mad. I still feel the way that they released him and all that was a little bit upsetting. It could have been handled a little bit better. And for everybody who says, well, he chose to leave, you're giving management and coaches too much credit. I mean, you know, he didn't have an option. They didn't want him on the practice field or on the sidelines because they would have felt bad about releasing him or benching him. So, yes, he got mad. Yes, he left the team. But they both made the decision. It was already made on both sides. They probably truly did not want Derek Carr around. So stop giving them credit. But okay, we're going to leave it at that. I'm tired of playing the blame game, the comparison game, and all that. And the toxicity on Twitter is just insane. On YouTube as well. And it really, really gets to me. I'm a very emotional person. Clearly, you guys see that. And I become toxic as well. So I had to remove myself a little bit. But I'm doing a post-game review. Because I feel a little bit blessed today. And I just wanted to speak to everybody. And tell you I love you. Okay. For the people that hate me. Or call me pathetic and weak. For rooting on Derek Carr. Post-Raider history or legacy. All right, so let's quickly talk about the game today. A lot of people are still going to play the blame game, the comparison game, Jared Stidham versus Derek Carr, who would have won us the game, you know, blah, 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 while ignoring coaches, owners that make decisions as well. And I just want to say that, like, I don't really want to play the comparison game. But I'm an idiot as well sometimes. I just want to say that I do remember in the last Kansas City Chiefs game, we had an opportunity at tying the game and possibly winning it in overtime, but the coach went for two instead of kicking the extra point, I believe, and we lost the game. Okay, we were in that game. I think the score was like 34-31. The Chiefs scored 31 or 34 this week's game, and I think we scored 13 with Stidham at quarterback. I'm not comparing the two. I like the mobility of Stidham, but the team hasn't gotten better with Stidham, regardless of what people say about last week against the number one defense. Well, if Stidham had such a great game against the number one defense, why didn't he have a decent enough game against the Kansas City Chiefs with a worser, technically, defense? It's because the NFL now has a little bit of tape on Jared Stidham, and they could plan for him a little bit better. Plus, Josh McDaniels didn't have a lot of plays for Jared Stidham, really. And he probably exposed all his plays last week. So Kansas City had a little bit of an edge on defense. Okay? Again, no one quarterback is better. I'm not going to play that game. I like Stidham. I like the pride and poise, what he's trying to do, how he's trying to ingrain himself with the Raiders. Him and his wife, they're wearing jerseys everywhere they go. They're wearing silver and black. He's doing media, trying to take the team on his back. But that being said, there's also a propaganda push by the Raiders press department to get the fans to like Jared Stidham, to get a little bit of the controversy off of Josh McDaniels' back per his decisions. We did have a fan that had a sign that said, like, you know, fire McDaniels, keep Derek Carr escorted out of the stadium last week with his sign. Maybe it happened this week. They showed Mark Davis this week in the booth. He didn't look too happy. Charles Woodson was with him. So I think all is good there. But the media did talk a lot of good about Jared Stidham. Like I said, the propaganda push has started because this Derek Carr situation exposed a lot of things within the organization, within the coaching staff, and, you know, everybody's on different sides of the fence. So the propaganda tool has to ingratiate the fans and try to get them to come back to the Raiders. Again, the truth of it all is Raiders are Raiders regardless, and 95% of us are always going to come back no matter how mad the Raiders piss us off. Okay? But there's a lot of toxic Raider fans out there that like to talk crap, you know, personally to people about whatever side of the fence they sit on. And I don't appreciate that. You want to call yourself a Raider Nation and you want to be like at least a part of my family, you got to have some empathy. When people are hurting, just let them hurt. Don't talk shit about their favorite player leaving. Let them be hurt. Let them heal. Let them yell. Let them rant. Let them rave. Let them heal. Regardless if you disagree. If you're a Raider family member, that's what you need to do. And many of you, even some Raider creators that I thought I was good friends with, didn't really show any empathy. And they talk crap. And it hurts my soul. The Raiders lost in the same old fashion. Bad defense, regardless of any excuses. We didn't have all the right players. We're playing young players. We picked up players off of free agency last week. We brought up players from the practice squad. Blah, 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 blah. A lot of people said Derek Carr had no more excuses. Well, again, what are the excuses that are starting for McDaniels? For Mark Davis, for Jared Stidham, possibly. So Derek Carr's no excuses run has ended, and possibly to other fans of other players, their excuse run begins. Believe me, I've been on both sides of that. Raiders lost again. Same old, same old. I'm just really frustrated at this entire season. I'm frustrated the last 15, 20, 30 years of being a Raider fan. And after COVID and everything, we were all looking to positivity with Devontae Adams. We were looking good. And then, you know, everything happened last year that was really, really bad. And again, all the players, Derek Carr included, were able to lead the team to a playoff run and almost beat the Bengals, or at least tie the game up. and it felt good. It felt like there was a lot of positivity. Then everything happened that had to have happened this year. And even the people that are toxic, that I'm calling toxic, they're mad as well. They act happy. Oh, Derek Carr is gone. I'm so happy. But the truth is, they're upset as well at the entire franchise and everything about it. But they're picking a person to blame without realizing the bigger picture. We're all pretty upset at everything. Everything. And we all need something to blame or someone to blame. And that's why every week, normally, every quarterback or coach says it's on me. They take on the blame. So who do we blame for this loss? We blame all of us. Let's blame all of us, Raider fans. Let's take on the blame. Let's ease our coaches, our players of some of the blame. Put it on us, even though it ain't on us at all. Let's just do it. And another thing that makes me sad about this organization is a lot of fans were divided when they moved from Oakland to Las Vegas. A lot of new fans were created to make money. And now it's just a business entity. And there's a sea of red the last 2 weeks in the stadium. I can't attribute that. I cannot attribute that to Derek Carr being benched. But I can attribute that to bad decision making, non-wins, more losses, high prices, bad ownership, not respecting the fans, and not listening to the fans and what they want and how they want to proceed. That's why for the past 2 or 3 weeks, the opposing team had more people in the stands in our home stadium. And that's sad. That's sad AF. But let's be honest. Does Mark Davis really care? No, because the fans of the other team still have to pay the exorbitant prices for the tickets. While many real, pure-hearted Raider fans get priced out, and then they just don't want to spend a whole day and a whole trip while after losing possibly their quarterback to see another game where we lose in the end or we lost just how we did versus the Kansas City Chiefs. It feels really sad. But all of this needed to happen. It is fate, and it is what it is. I'm always going to be a Raider fan. I'm going to have to take breaks once in a while. I'm always going to critique our team, critique our players, because I am some sort of a YouTube criticist or media personality or somebody that just needs to make a few bucks and needs to talk to somebody or what I call my friends online about my always favorite team. My heart is pure. I try not to be a toxic Raider creator. I try not to be a toxic negative Raider fan. I try my best, but I fail all the time. I do love the world of conspiracies because I think they happen more than not. Whether you believe in all of them, I like doing them, I like talking about them, and it helps calm my brain. It gives me something to focus on. I have a very overactive brain. So I'm going to end it with this. Thank you guys for rocking with me. I'm going to start doing some more shows upcoming, probably in the next week or so. I got to make a little bit of money. I'm struggling. I don't have a job. So I'm going to try my best to become a personality, get some views, make a few bucks. Speaking, and I just wanted to say this, I've been thinking a lot about our very close games, meaning our one score close games that we've lost. If somebody is really hardworking enough or very good at gambling or reporting, I would look into the gambling stats of Las Vegas, you know, after halftime. Meaning, like, we went up like 14 points or whatever in a lot of the games, or over 10 points. And then after second half, we couldn't even score. Like, Davante Adams wouldn't get the ball or whatever. Or, you know, like, the game plan just seemed like it changed. People can blame Carr, McDaniels, whatever. But look into the gambling aspects of it. How close were the games? Like, you know, the difference? Like, were the Raiders -3, you know, before the game started? How close did the game end? Because I'm just going to be honest, y'all. You can make bets after halftime as well. So we look really good at halftime, and then people bet the over-under. People bet, you know, how many more points, the average, whatever. There's so many bets you can make, even for players, that after halftime, we lost a lot of those games. Then in games that we should have won, like the New Orleans, or should have been in close, we didn't score a point. And then like 9 or 10 games were one-score games. I don't know the over-unders, but if I was a reporter and I had the energy and the know-how, a lot of people made a lot of money. A lot of people made a lot of money. Maybe on the Raiders staff, maybe they had people bet that we don't even know about. I don't know. I'm not trying to throw out accusations, but I'm just saying, a lot of people made a lot of money with our effed up games. At the end, whether covering the spread or after halftime, or players not catching the ball, or being favored and then losing without scores. A lot of people made a lot of money. Some of those people might be around or into the Raiders organization. Just a thought I had. I'll leave you to that. I love you, Raider Nation. God bless you. Happy New Year. Try to figure out what will make your life better and start to pursue it. No matter what it is, big or small, find something that'll make your life better and do it. We need to get rid of this toxic world. We need to get rid of it. I know we can't, but we can at least try. And the Damar Hamlin situation brought a lot of the world together with empathy and love. And I want that for the Raider Nation moving forward. I'm going to try to bring it to you as best as I can. I will fail, but I'm going to try. I love you, Raider Nation. God bless. I'll talk to you soon.